Louisiana Beer Reviews, Terrapin, their Monster Beer Tour, Wake and Bake Oatmeal Coffee Stout, 9.4% alcohol here at 5:42 a.m. It says right here, wake up with beer. Well, that's what I'm doing. Well, I've been up almost an hour, about an hour. And this is the 10th anniversary of this beer, 2004 to 2014, brewed in Georgia. I guess they're trying to compete with the breakfast stout from Founders of Michigan. Before I get started. Okay, Quentin, how you feel? You feel played? You feel bad? You guaranteed they were gonna beat the brakes off the Pelicans? What happened, Quentin? What's wrong? What happened, baby? Man, that sounds bad. Okay, I heard those sirens before I started recording, said a little prayer. And I have some of this Progresso Vegetable Classics green split pea soup. Put some sriracha sauce in it, black pepper, some cheese. This is from Progresso, which is now a General Mills brand, but Progresso started at Progress Grocery in New Orleans, Louisiana. And then, like so many small companies, they were bought out. Happens in beer, happens in food. And I have put some Manda's hot sausage in there. A link of it from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. I have coffee and chicory. Now I'm pouring it straight in to release the esters like the brewers recommend. I'm getting the thinnest little beige head, and it's a dark brown, essentially black appearance. I guess under light you might pick up some black highlights, but in the dark here, it's not showing it. I like the KBS. Not the KBS. That's the one I haven't had yet. The breakfast stout. And Dan Stein told me that the KBS wasn't in Louisiana yet. But I gave it only an A, only an A, only most excellent. Because, well, the soup is good. And we're used to drinking strong coffee down here, coffee and chicory and intense foods. So I don't know if we were as overwhelmed maybe as other people that eat lower profile, milder foods. So that could be an issue, although I did like it, there's no doubt about it. Too hot. Now, they're saying, they don't give the ingredients on the website, they're just talking about they add coffee, this brand of coffee that they have. You can look on their website, you can buy the coffee too. World class on Beer Advocate, the bros say world class, highest possible score, 99 out of 100 on Rate Beer, 92 out of 100 for the stout. Now, their Founders Breakfast Stout on Rate Beer, for example, is getting 100 and 100 for both overall and stout. That's a winner. Unusual food for breakfast. I know soup. I don't want to eat it. Now the aroma on this beer is sort of intense. It's dark, dark, dark roasted barley malts, sweetness, the coffee, I guess. Spice in the soup and get it all spicy hot, and then it makes my nose run. It'll clear your sinuses. Yeah, it's not overwhelmingly aromatic, but it's there. Now the flavor is sort of bold though. It's the thick mouthfeel, medium to thick, but on the thick side, heavy. The dark roasted barley malt, the chocolatiness, the dark fruits maybe. Certainly the black coffee. Now, if you don't like coffee, you're probably not going to like it. I know a guy, and I said, this beer is like dark roasted coffee, so I don't like coffee. He didn't like the beer. But carbonation now, and I just took a few sips. Listen to that. The finish is a little powdery, a little bitty bit alcoholic, because it's 9.4, so you're picking up that a bit. The IBUs, you know, the bitterness is there, but it's not super. I'm thinking it's probably around 80, but it may not present itself that high because of the sweetness. So I would say it's definitely up there with the Founders, and seems like it has a little bit more character than the Founders Breakfast Stout, like a little bit sweeter, more bitter, a little bolder. And that was my only thing about that one. I was expecting it to be so bold, and I was expecting this one to not be that great because I'm not super in love with Terrapin beers but I think I'm going to go to an A+ with this one instead of the just the A like I did on the Breakfast Stout. But certainly both of them are ones to try. I'm not recommending that you drink beer with breakfast. I don't recommend people do that. I only drank 4 beers throughout the whole day if I'm off, like here. Morning, afternoon, later afternoon, evening, that's it. So anyway, laissez-les bon temps rouler. An outstanding beer, and I'm going to end this review by saying, y'all come on down to Baton Rouge and go to a Louisiana State University and A&M College Tigers basketball game.